Finally, the last thing that you'll see for each chapter is a knowledge test. If you click on the knowledge test and read the instructions, you'll see that you get 2 attempts per chapter and there's no time limit. The objective of a knowledge test isn't to have you memorize the entire chapter and then you're tested on your ability to memorize the chapter. The idea of the knowledge test is to pull out key information from the chapter as you're reading it so that you know that you're on pace to finish the chapter and you're acknowledging the things that are important. The chapters can be really big sometimes and it's hard to tell what's important from what's not as important if you're a Photoshop novice. So these questions are going to lead you in the direction of things that are more important than others in the chapter. A couple things of note with the knowledge test. The questions are in the order that you'll read them in your textbook. And so what I recommend as your instructor is to answer these questions as you're reading the book. And you can come and go in a knowledge test as long as you don't hit submit. So when you click to take the knowledge test, start reading chapter 1. And note that the first question says, images in Photoshop are displayed using bitmap properties, which allow for the image to be arranged in a series of geometric or mapping of dots. Each dot represents one color or shade. What is another name for the basic element of an image in Photoshop? I would recommend launching the chapter in the e-textbook and read until you start learning about what the basic element of an image is. And when you find that answer, you can find the correct answer as of the choices listed, and then you can move on to question 2. I would encourage you not to simply skim the chapter and look for the answers to the questions, because there are other things in the chapter that you should be doing or reading about that aren't specifically covered. These are just kind of pointing in the right direction of some things that are important. Most importantly, these are questions. They're knowledge-based. They're not practical. They're not hands-on or skills-based. And so the chapter is going to talk about how to do things, open images, close images, reset workspaces, change a color mode, change a file format, crop an image, and different things like that. You need to actually do those activities in the book as you're reading through it so that you get the skills-based approach, and then these knowledge tests support the knowledge learning. I think it's important to know why things work the way they do. A lot of students take the Photoshop class and they think, well, I just want to kind of make a pretty picture. But I think in order to make that pretty picture, you need to know how to set up the framework for the file. And then most importantly, you need to know how to communicate that to an audience, and you need to know how to prepare your files properly for different types of outputs and different resolutions and different intentions. And that's what we're going to cover this semester.